sailing. But where?
Through the darkness of future past, the magician longs to see. One chance out between two worlds. Fire, walk with me.
Oh, what a crop of mummy feet. traveling major spoke of are more than distant orbs. They are, in fact, a clock. A clock that tells a time. A time? Time draws nearer with each ticking talk.
Most of us inhabit at least two worlds. The real world, where we're at the mercy of circumstance, and the world within, the unconscious, a safe place where we can escape. The Max shifts between these worlds against his will. Here, homeless, he lives in a box in an alley. The only one who really cares for him is Julie Winters, a freelance social worker. But in Pangea, the other world, he rules the Outback and is the protector of Julie. He's Jungle Queen. There, he cares for her, but he always ends up back in the real world. And me, old Mr. Gone, only I can see that the secret which unites them could destroy them. I could be helpful. Screw it. I think I'll have some fun with them first.
Well, what are friends for?
Yes, and he is a friend, Jerry. He's reliable. He's considerate. He's like your exact opposite.
So he's Bizarro Jerry.
Bizarro Jerry?
Yeah, like Bizarro Superman. Superman's exact opposite. Who lives in the backwards Bizarro world? Up is down, down is up. He says hello when he leaves, goodbye when he arrives.
Shouldn't he say bad bye? Isn't that the opposite of goodbye?
No, it's still goodbye.
Does he live underwater?
No.
Is he black?
Look, just forget the whole thing, all right?
Team of miniatures was amazing.
No, he's so tiny.
Yeah. Hey, guys. Elaine, sit down. These are a couple of my friends. This is Gene, and this guy we just called Feldman.
The Bizarro world.
Once upon a time, there was a place of great goodness called the White Lodge. Gentle fawns gambled there amidst happy, laughing spirits. The sounds of innocence and joy filled the air. And when it rained sweet nectar that infused one's heart with a desire to live life in truth and beauty. Generally speaking, a ghastly place, reeking of virtue's sour smell. Engorged with the whispered prayers of kneeling mothers, mewling newborns, and fools, young and old, compelled to do good without reason. But I am happy to point out that our story does not end in this wretched place of saccharine excess. For there's another place, its opposite. A place of almost unimaginable power, chock full of dark forces and vicious secrets. No prayers dare enter this frightful maw. Spirits there care not for good deeds or priestly invocations. They as like to rip the flesh from your bone as greet you with a happy good day. And if harnessed, these spirits in this hidden land of unmuffled screams and broken hearts would offer up a power so vast that its bearer might reorder the earth itself to his liking. Oh. This place I speak of is known as the Black Lodge, and I intend to find it.
Sunlit world of what he believes to be reality. But there is, unseen by most, an underworld, a place that is just as real, but not as brightly lit. A dark side.
Exist, it probably exists at a point in time. Now, an object such as a door normally exists at a point in time and space. By way of contrast, a shooting star normally exists at at a point in time over a continuum of space. But taken from the star's point of view, it's a completely different experience.
You just lost me.
Told John to turn and look around.
Oh, yes.
He wiped away
Six.
Oh, yes.
The forces of nature entered into conflict.
Oh, yes.
The sun turned black like a cyclone of hell.
Oh, yes.
The moon turned to blood and we're streaming through the air.
Oh, yes.
The heavens departed like a great big stroke.
Oh, yes.
And struck terror into every wicked remnant.
Oh, yes.
Men went running and screaming through the dust.
Oh, yes.
Flying rocks and mountains all on us.
Oh, yes.
While that great, great day shall be able to stand the judgment storm.
Oh, yes.
Who shall be able
to stand the storm?
Who shall be able
to stand the storm?
Who shall be able
to stand the storm?
Oh, yeah.
Open up the book of the seven seals.
And when the Lamb had opened seal number seven,
oh, yes.
A solid half power that was silent in heaven.
Oh, yes.
Hellfire and blood for God and all for frightening.
Oh, yes.
The trumpet to blow it so loud.
Oh, yes.
One foot on land, the other on sea.
Oh, yes.
He raised his right hand to proclaim his decree.
Oh, yes.
For him that liveth, the mighty is swore.
Oh, yes.
Time has been, won't be no more.
Oh, yes.
Sealed.
Oh, yes.
Another mighty host had been revealed.
Oh, yes.
The number that